We know that Latvia produces the Patria 6x6 APC through a deal arranged with the Finnish defence company and the Baltic countries' participation in the CAVS program. But apparently, Lithuania makes armoured personnel carriers as well. There are some peculiarities with what's being presented, including the age of the company and the design. So let's dig deeper into what's going on. In a recent video, we discussed how Lithuanian President Gitanas Nausėda hinted at a possible deal for armoured personnel carriers, or APCs, from Finnish defence firm Patria. Someone left a comment on the video saying that Lithuania produced the Taurus APC and that the government should be buying domestic. And while Taurus and APC and Lithuania didn't appear in the top search results, we eventually found out what this was all about. The Taurus is a platform offered by the Orida engineering company. Going through this firm's website, we see that there are several 4x4 variants, the 4-1, 4-2, and 4-3. Each of these is a different design with varying engine sizes, payloads, gross weights, and levels of protection. Then we have the Taurus 6, which is an all-terrain 6x6 personnel carrier, and the Taurus 8, an 8x8 APC. Exciting news, right? Who knew that Lithuania had its own military vehicle manufacturer? According to the company website, Orida Engineering Company is a, quote, center of engineering excellence in the defense industry where armored transport platforms are developed from the initial design through to finished operational vehicle. The company adds that its solutions offer top-tier protection, mobility, and versatility founded upon modular architecture and a fully integrated manufacturing process. Each Taurus model is engineered to withstand extreme conditions and ensure maximum effectiveness in real-world operations. But if we do some digging, there is more than meets the eye with this company. First off, checking its publicly registered business records, we can see that Orida Engineering Company has a total of one insured employee. Its age at the time of making this video is just a little over 7 months, having been founded in early 2025. That's not much of a surprise why we haven't heard of them before. They're even newer than this YouTube channel. The thing is, while Orida Engineering Company is fairly new, it appears to have a parent company that is much older, Panevežio Orida, which literally translates to Orida of Panevežys. This company, in its current legal form, is about 32 years old, but has roots going back all the way to 1907. It has 29 insured employees and a declared revenue of 1.64 million euros in 2024. Unfortunately, after factoring in expenses, this was a net loss of nearly 700,000 euros. It's more likely this parent company that is being described on the Orida engineering site when it says, "We are a metal processing and engineering solutions company based in Panevežys, operating modern industrial infrastructure that enables us to work with steel constructions, apply advanced manufacturing methods, and adapt to individual technical requirements." After this, the website adds, "We aspire to become Lithuania's leading manufacturer of armored military vehicles, actively participating in national defense transport development and assembly projects, whilst placing considerable emphasis on strengthening supply chain independence." So, from the information we've presented thus far, you can see that the defense and military vehicle production side is much newer and just getting started. So, do vehicles even exist in physical form? Well, we know of at least one. Indeed, the company's Taurus 4-1 was presented at the international exhibition known as MSPO in Poland in early September. You can see images here from various angles and with various people. Here's what the interior looks like as well. According to a Facebook post by the Lithuanian Defense and Security Industry Association, the head of Orida Engineering Company says that up to 80% of all mechanical processing and final assembly work is performed in the factory at Panevežys, ensuring the reliability of the supply chain and a high part of the local added value. It's also important that the company carries out local maintenance. Discussing the vehicle within our team, our Lithuanian-American Army veteran Julius commented, "It looks very much like a South African Marauder, doesn't it?" And after a quick Google search by team member Christoph, we realise that the design is nearly identical. Like copyright infringement level identical. What do you think after seeing these vehicles side by side? Now, we're not saying that Auridos Engineering stole the design of the Paramount Group's Marauder vehicle. Doing so would be absolutely foolish. Our best guess is that Auridos has licensed the design from Paramount. You know, in the same way that Polish manufacturer Rossomach has licensed some designs from Patria. Here's the Patria AMV, and here's the Rossomach AMV. Here's the Patria 6x6, and here's the Rossomach KTO 6x6. Describing the Rossomach arrangement as a successful case study, Patria says that its AMV 8x8 manufacturing technology was transferred to Rossomach. The technology transfer was extensive, since the company did not have previous experience of modern vehicle production. Patria adds that entire vehicle production capability was transferred, and Polish industry has been widely utilized for parts and sub-assembly production for the Polish AMV vehicle. And so, if this is the first time you're hearing that such a thing can be done, well, now you know. And this is likely how Aurida will go about producing armored military vehicles for Lithuania. So, again, it wouldn't be a surprise if all of this is part of a technology transfer and licensing agreement. On the more cynical side, it could seem like an opportunistic move for Lithuanian companies to make these big pivots to military and defense, given how much money will be flowing into the sector. And as we all know, it's simply good politics to source from local companies. At the same time, we see that Aurida is a well-established company with many years of experience. Not experienced in manufacturing whole vehicles, but rather just automotive compressors. But as Patria highlighted in its relations with Rossomach, it is possible to successfully develop this capability within a company that has little experience in modern vehicle production. And so we'll have to wait and see where this goes. Lithuania is growing its land forces to become a division, and we think this expansion will need APCs. If the country is eyeing Patria armored vehicles, then there's a good chance there will be some technology transfer to enable Lithuanian production and/or assembly. As such, Aurida is well positioned to be chosen. But what do you think of Aurida and its Taurus vehicles? Let us know by leaving a comment.